got to be careful. Very small, subtle change, but please do put your eyes on the PR interval, PR segment, if there's absent PR interval, P wave, and then directly QRS, it is WPW. And there is a P wave and there is a slurring, it is WPW. So short PR interval, prolonged QRS interval, slurring on the upstroke of the R wave. This one was chest pain and dyspnea. Yes? Students, residents? Simultaneous inversions in the inferior leads as well as in the anterior and the lateral leads, and a mild of a right axis deviation probably. Okay. Pulmonary embolism, right. So whenever you see the simultaneous T wave inversions in the inferior as well as in the anterior lead, with that kind of history, you should suspect. What I'm saying is, don't go always with the ACS. It is ACS, NSTEMI. No, keep your differentials wide initially to start off. So, T wave abnormality consistent with the inferior and anterior ischemia may indicate a pulmonary embolism. So, whenever you see simultaneous T wave inversion in the inferior and anteroseptal lead, you should consider pulmonary embolism. With exertional palpitations and lightheadedness, I've already put the arrows, deep Q waves, high left ventricular voltages and deep Q waves. Yesterday, Dr. Digambar was talking about HOCM and he showed us a 2D echo also of the HOCM. Deep Q waves in the lateral lead. With the history, you should suspect HOCM, send that patient for the 2D echocardiography, systolic anterior motion of the mitral valve. So in summary, the killer ECG patterns that you have is hyperkalemia, TCA poisoning, digoxin toxicity, Brugada, cardiac tamponade. Yeah, we've done all of them. So ECG interpretation is essentially a pattern recognition. We need to calibrate our pattern and recognition skills by looking at more and more ECGs. Do follow up. Amal Mattu's ECGs are really very helpful. He has book 1, book 2 with 100 ECGs in both and with the interpretation given on the back. First, don't go on the back and see the interpretation. Write down your interpretation and then you find out. Okay, so pick up 5 ECGs, write down, and then you can go ahead. We need to follow up our own patient. That's very important for the EM physician. We get so busy with our next day that you forget to follow up your patient which has gone previously. So follow up is also very important to see whether what we did was correct and anything better could have been done. ECG in isolation is rarely sensitive or specific enough to make a firm diagnosis. All these killer ECG patterns require clinical correlation and or confirmatory investigation. So clinical correlation is the most important thing that you need. This was my student who did DM from GS Medical. These are my references. And thank you.
Okay, so one of the finest session. Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. And if I have to say in leadership, I can only say, well, madam, you saw the last session, last talk. Badi muddat se mile aap. Badi muddat se mile aap. Aap se milna bada achha laga. Vaise to ECG ke swimming pool mein tairna sabhi jante hain. Vaise to ECG ke swimming pool mein tairna sabhi jante hain. Lekin aapke ECG ke gyan sagar mein doobna achha laga. Thank you. May I request Dr. Bhoi to present memento to our guest speakers. Dr. Rajeshwari, Dr. Ajay, yeah, please, at the center, sort of, sir. Yeah, dena hai, unko sabhi ko dena hai. Lights, action. Up, madam, Dr. Ajay. Dr. Bijal, our chairperson. Yeah, photo set is a gaina. And there is one nice poem in Marathi. Denaryane deta jave, ghenaryane gheta jave, gheta gheta denaryache hata ghave. With this poem, I request Dr. Bhoi sir to present memento to Dr. Digambar. Yes, and are begin fast. And for this chair, for this session, there was supposed to be one more chairperson who came 4 minutes and 22 seconds late. So he opted to sit on the last seat. Ye agar shayarane andaaz mein kehna, to what I would like to say, raaste bhar ro ro ke poocha humse paon ke chhalon ne. रास्ते भर रो रो के पूछा हमसे पांव के छालों ने इतनी दूर बस्ती क्यों बसा ली है दिल में बसने वालों ने डॉक्टर गुरुप्रसाद नायक एमिनेंट कार्डियोलॉजिस्ट फ्रॉम गोवा मेडिकल कॉलेज अ बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन अ मोमेंटो टू डॉक्टर गुरुप्रसाद आई थिंक वी आर ऑलमोस्ट फिनिशिंग एनीथिंग यू वुड लाइक टू
Yesterday, Dr. Manjunath gave us a beautiful lecture, and Dr. Guru is Dr. Manjunath's boss. Whatever you heard yesterday happening in Goa, this Dr. Guru Naik is the man who is doing it.
Please say something for us about your cardiology in Goa. We want to hear. Just a few words. About okay. The cardiology work that you do in Goa.
Sure, I just you are when working abroad. Now you are in Goa. What you're feeling? What are your feelings for doing?
So we started cardiology department about 5 years ago, five and a half years ago, and that was the new department in Goa Medical College. So we've grown very quickly over 5 years. We have about 6 cardiologists now. And it's a very fairly busy department. Goa Medical College has over 1,000 beds. We have a small unit, but fairly rapid turnover, and where we do the whole range of cardiology procedures, treatments, take care of all emergencies. I won't say that we do anything special, but that was the first department. That was a new department that we started 5 years ago.
Do it free to anybody.
No. I mean, that's thanks to the government, I think. I mean, Goa government has been very good. And
you have audience from all over the country.
Yeah, so Goa government has been very good. And Goa has a health insurance scheme, the Deen Dayal Swasthya Yojana, which all Goan residents are eligible for. But we treat, of course, anybody that comes in. Even patients without insurance will get free treatment for acute MI. Any emergency procedures, any emergency treatment will take care of them, thanks to Goa government policies. So, for example, just before coming, we had a 30-year-old male, a laborer working at the airport, obviously, no insurance, not a Goan resident by legal status, had an acute MI and had an angioplasty. So we don't, thanks to Goa government, we don't really ask questions, just take care of the emergencies. And therefore, it's very nice to work there. You don't really have to worry whether the patient is paying or not, but you're still able to take care of him. So I think that's the best part of it. Thank you.
And I would be very happy to spend some time with Dr. Bhoi, Dr. Vivek. They have lots to offer to Goa, to your hands. And please stay with us in the evening. Spend some time with them. We were planning to meet the health minister. We could not get an appointment, okay? Yeah.
As a concluding remark of this Ashirvachan, I request Bohi sir to say a few words.
So, before I give concluding remarks, I'll ask Dr. Vivek to be with me here on the podium because he's also our director for MCARD. So before we, sir, yeah. So it was really a wonderful, you know, moment, you know, in the journey of emergency medicine, which we actually, you know, began some, you say, 15 years back, the journey from casualty to emergency medicine. Now the new chapter we are going to write is in terms of, you know, improving the care in the emergency, especially for patients coming with acute cardiac emergency, is going to a new chapter which we wrote along with the team of our Professor Praveen Agarwal sir, Dr. Digambar Naik, Dr. Vivek, and all of you. It was a new chapter in the journey of improving care where actually it matters. So before the experts can reach, you know, experts are already in our country, already there is excellent, you know, definitive care, whether it is cardiology, neurology, nephrology, all lodges. But what is the system which is lacking is the initial chain of survival. When the patient becomes sick at home and to health-seeking behavior, lack of health-seeking behavior, to the pre-hospital care, and route in the ambulance, when they reaches the ER, and then definitive care takes over. So this chain is weakest link in our country, and we are quite passionate. Last 15 years, you know, has been a great journey, and especially I want to make a statement here because we are very passionate to develop, you know, both the compendium of strong emergency care linked with the definitive care like cardiology, especially in cardiac emergency. So we are a passionate group and we want, even in Goa, you know, you have a good pre-hospital care service. The slight weak link which we feel is when the patient reaches the emergency, the casualty. So we have to change the game from casualty to emergency medicine, sir. And that is, internationally it is already there, and you must be, you are quite aware of that. And in India also, almost 30 medical schools have already adopted MD emergency medicine. And more than 60 hospitals, 60 programs are already there in DNB emergency medicine. So it will be a good idea because you are a senior person and because we want to, you know, improve that aspect. So whatever effort it takes, we need to build up that program even in Goa. So with these words, thank everybody to be here, and we'd like to again, you know, invite you, and it is strong participation from everybody. There's a lot of enthusiasm, you know, and this is quite exciting field, and because it is high adrenaline stuff, you know, both for the patient as well as the person who manages the patient, right from the patient when he, you know, goes out of the ambulance to reach the cardiology, it is all about adrenaline. So with this adrenaline, let's come back again next year, and with more things are in place, Dr. Digambar, and we have already going to have a great discussion, already announced the dates, you know.
8th and 9th of May 2020, same place.
And finally, I'll give the mic to Vivek to say a few words before we conclude, before we just say final few words.
You can register on the reception today, sir. Yeah. Before you go. Very special offer, discount.
Oh. Yeah. So, I want to thank everybody who is present here and who is not present here but has been part of MCARD, the team of Dr. Digambar, the hotel personnel, and the comparer, Doc Sab, and everybody who has been supporting us throughout this journey. Thank you all, and we wish to welcome you all next year. Come with your families. This is a beautiful location. for a family vacation and also the Feast of Knowledge. We are definitely going to improve the scientific content next year. We are going to add more workshops to this, and we are also, those who are interested in doing fellowship, just keep on looking at the ECE website. We'll be having a fellowship in emergency cardiology very soon. Thank you so much.
As a part of the organizers, there's something called as Uttar Puja, and we always say, by virtue, it's a Sanskrit sloka, but I just say the meaning of that. By virtue of our actions, deeds, perception, knowingly or unknowingly, if we have failed in our duty as the host, please be kind-hearted and forgive us, because finally, we all believe, Atithi Devo Bhava. You are all God for us. Tujhme Rab Dikhta Hai Yaro. So with these words, I hope you are going to enjoy today's session equally. And in fact, today we want all of you to sing, dance, and take the pleasant memories of this beautiful Goa in your hearts forever. Rahi bahar, to phool khilte rahenge. Aur rahi arzu, to dosto hum yun hi milte rahenge. Thank you.
मोहब्बत हो गई है मुझे पलकों की छांव में एहसान तेरा हो का मुझ पर दिल चाहता है वो कहने दो मुझे तुमसे मोहब्बत हो गई है मुझे पलकों की छांव में एहसान तेरा हो का मुझ पर तुमने मुझको हंसना सिखाया सिखाया रोने कहोगे रो लेंगे अब रोने कहोगे रो लेंगे आंसू का हमारे गम न कर वो बहते हैं तुम बहने दो मुझे तुमसे मोहब्बत हो गई है पलकों की छांव में रहने दो एहसान तेरा हो का मुझ पर चाहे बना दो चाहे मिटा दो
चुराना सनम बदल के